آیات of the Quran وللہ المشرق والمغرب فأینما تولوا فثم وجه الله. It says to Allah belongs the east and the west, and whichsoever way you turn is the presence of Allah. So in his commentary he quotes Wordsworth, William Wordsworth, an English poet, who says, a paraphrase of this, as if he had been reading this, he said, whose dwelling, Allah's dwelling, where he stays, not literally, whose dwelling is the light of setting suns, and the round ocean and the living air, and in the blue sky and in the mind of man, a motion and a spirit that impels all thinking things, all objects of all thought, and rolls through all things. He's describing Allah. Where? فَأَيْنَمَا تَوَلُّوا فَسَمَّ وَجْهُ اللَّهِ. And whosoever way you turn is the presence of Allah. Wherever you look, Allah is present everywhere. He says 100% mark for that. All this, language, English, subject-wise, what do you want to know? Whatever you want to know, Allah, what you want to know? You want to know about the Quran, what does the Quran say about the Quran? Open Q. Everything the Quran says about the Quran. You want to know about our Nabi and the Imam said Muhammad, everything about Muhammad, what the book says about Muhammad. You want to know about Moses, Musa alayhi salam, and the Imam Moses, everything that the book says about Musa alayhi salam. You want to know about Ibrahim alayhi salam and the Abraham. You find everything about Abraham in the Quran. You want to know about marriage, everything about marriage in the Quran. Divorce, everything about divorce in the Quran. What do you want to know? Everything on your fingertips. And how much? 5 rands. I just heard that you have a good custom that when your daughters get married, you do give them a Quran as a wedding gift or something on parting. I said, right? Now for that, we'll have one with gold. Gold. See, this is the ordinary. Inside same. But gold doesn't make any difference with the inside. Page for page is the same. Only outside is gold. So when you give your daughters, give them in gold. Of course, it'll cost you 15 rands. 15 rands. Still, it's below my cost. It will cost me 25 rands to put the gold all together. With the book, 25 rands, you get for 15 rands. Still, you're getting 10 rands back for nothing. This one here cost me 20 rands. I said, look, you can have it for 5. What better present can you give? Wedding present? Christmas present? Birthday present? Any excuse, man, give it to your employer, give it to your employee. Somebody working for you, give it to him. Your employer, give it to him. You have done your duty. On the day of judgment, they say, Ya Bari Ta'ala, no, I couldn't talk, I was afraid. I gave you a book, you must do the talking now. This is, you are the best advocate that there is. I just led the horse to the river, make him drink, that's your job. You make him drink now. And one little suggestion, that if you want to give this Quran, 5 rands, wallah, is so cheap. What you do, don't just give it away like that. Tell him, say, look, this book is an encyclopedia, it is, of 2,000 pages. I do not expect you to wade through it. We are all involved in a rat race. You know, we are so busy. You got time to go through a book like this, 2,000 pages? No. So I said, what you do, you just have a look at the index at the back. Anything, just browse through the index. What do you want to know? You want to know about man, the creation of man. You want to know about God. The overwhelming theme of this book is God. What do you want to know? You want to know about your Jesus. So I say, look at the J, Jesus. What does it say? Jesus. First item, under J, Jesus, a righteous prophet. He's a true prophet of God. Chapter 6, verse 85. His birth is described in 2 places. Chapter 3, verses 45 onwards. Chapter 19, verses 23 onwards. Let's have a look. Open. Read it to him. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ قالت الملائكة يا مريم. So behold, the angel said, O Mary, إن الله اصطفاك وطهرك واصطفاك على نساء العالمين. That God Almighty has chosen you, purified you, chosen you above the women of all nations. Read the Quran to him. Bacha the Quran. You don't know the impact that it has on the non-Muslim. The Allah's kalam, it has a power, it has moved people to ecstasy and tears. I have seen it happen to non-Muslims. When they hear the Quran chanted beautifully, the non-Muslims, they shiver and they shake. Read it to them. And give the translation before parting with the book. So look, anything you want to know, you just open the index and you find it. Everything about Jesus is there. And any questions, you come back to me and I'll be able to help you if I can. If not, I'll take you to my Shaykh, my Imam. So this is the suggestion, my dear brothers. I don't know whether the sisters are on the top, I don't know. But this is it. Acquaint yourself with Allah's Kalam. And once you allow Allah Bari Ta'ala to talk to you, because when you read it with understanding, He's talking to you. He's telling you and what He's expecting from you. Inshallah, you can never remain the same. You can't remain the same allowing Allah to talk to you. That when you realize that He's talking to you, He's instructing you, you can't remain the same. You can't sit on your backside doing nothing. As it is, we are all sitting on our backsides doing nothing. You know that? If we understood the book, the Arab supposed to be understanding the book. Supposed to be. No. He is reading the book, the Arab. I was thinking that the Arab now, you see, if my people, I'm thinking, could understand the book, will be all angels, wallah. All angels walking this earth. So I expect the same thing from the Arab. So when I meet them, I says, no, there's something gone wrong. They understand the Quran. But you know how they're understanding it? Allah is telling, describing it in the Quran. وَإِذَا تُطْلَى عَلَيْهِ عَيَاتُنَا قَالَ أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ So when our signs are rehearsed to them, they say these are tales of the ancients. These are fairy tales, folklore of old times. And Allah kata Allah Dawud wa Jaluta, and Dawud killed Jalut, and Allah made the Bani Israel into monkeys. This is for entertainment. They are not thinking that, look, Allah is now talking to them, that they are the monkeys today. They are making monkeys out of us. You don't have to have tail to become a monkey. We say, he made a monkey out of him. What? He's still handsome and young, good looking. No, we say, he's made a monkey out of him, means made a fool out of him. So, this is, we are becoming monkeys today. We are the Jalut today. 1,000 million and we can't even cry. You know that? 1,000 million Muslims and you can't even cry. Say, look, what are you doing to our children in Palestine? You know that? You can't even cry. What is this? The same, what the Mongols did to us, same. See, we won't bend down and wait for the Jew to come and chop off our head. But what is this? You tell me. That you can't even cry, you can't even say, what you're doing to my brothers. Can you? No. 1,000 million, nowhere in the world does a Muslim is able to cry and shout and say, what the hell are you doing to my people? Nothing. You know why? We have drifted away from the spirit of the Quran. Go back to the Quran. It will charge you. It'll electrify you. You'll be a changed person, wallah. Then life is cheap. Life becomes cheap. At the moment, you have divisions. We have divisions. You know why? Because we got our own heroes. Everybody's got his own hero. I don't know what my hero says. I said, this is Muhammad is your hero. And Allah's Kalam is your book of direction. Once we have this as a common denominator between us, as soon as there is a dispute, argument, he says, Akhi, look, let's open to Allah's Kalam. Let's see what Allah says. Okay? You can't disagree, sir. Let's see what Allah says. Look, this is what Allah says. Immediately. There's a common denominator. Wallah, there'll be peace and harmony. So, with these words, my dear brethren, I don't know, I have taken so much of your time. If there are any questions on what I have said, if I made any mistakes, you think that I shouldn't have said, it is a good opportunity for you to rectify me. Says, Uncle, look, we don't agree with you. Our forefathers were not brought here. You know, we fell from heaven. We came in a flying saucer. Okay, now whatever you want to tell me, I'm prepared to listen to you. How you came here, you know. I may be wrong. So any questions regarding how to deal with the enemy? The Nasara, so the guy comes along and... Here, we have got something for you, some little homework to do, very easy, pleasant. Can I have one of those strips, those cartoons? Somebody who's brought it. Now we have got some beautiful comic strips. You know, our children love comics. There have been people complaining to me that our children, you know, they don't want to read the Quran. I said, have you got the Quran at home? No. Yeah, they don't want to read the Quran. I said, have you got one at home? He says, no. What do you know? Look, make it available, number one. Number two, make it a habit around the family. So look, once a week, don't be over enthusiastic. Once a week, once a week, Ba'd al-Maghrib, after dinner, get the family around the table, and your young brother or your sister, he said, look, read it and explain to Ma. Read it and explain to Ma. You know what you're doing? You're making it to go through the child's mind actively. The child reads the Arabic,